JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for November the 25th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar continued to drift north against most of the other major currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session on Thursday. It underperformed only versus the Canadian dollar, while it was found virtually unchanged against the Swiss franc. The greenback gained the most versus the Kiwi and the Japanese yen. Now, the strengthening of the greenback and the safe haven franc, combined with the weakening of the risk-linked Kiwi, suggests that financial markets may have traded in a risk-off fashion once again. However, the strengthening of the loonie and the weakening of the yen point otherwise. Therefore, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the overall investor morale, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Now, here, most of the major European indices, at least under our radar, were lower or unchanged. The only gainer was Italy's FTSE MIB, due to Telecom Italia taking another shot in the arm, surging 15.6% following reports that the US fund KKR is considering boosting its offer for the company. Now, later in the day, sentiment improved in Wall Street, with the S&P 500 and Nasdaq trading in positive waters and Dow Jones staying near its opening levels. Today in Asia, the picture was more mixed. Now, yesterday we said that we expect US indices to rebound the trade higher soon, despite increasing expectations over a quicker removal of monetary stimulus by the Fed. In our view, most investors have already digested that idea, convinced by recent comments from several Fed policymakers, as well as by the reappointment of Jerome Powell as the Fed chief. This is also evident by the fact that the S&P 500, especially Nasdaq, gained despite the minutes of the latest FOMC, revealing that officials have been considering a faster tapering pace and sooner rate hikes since then. Thus, we stick to our guns that the US dollar may stay strong at a time when investors are willing to buy stocks, and this is conditional upon economic data confirming the resilience of the US economy. Now, in Europe, the picture is not so bright. We believe that equities here may stay under pressure for a while more, and this may be due to increasing COVID cases and the imposition of fresh restrictive measures. As we noted yesterday, although the flash PMIs for November surprised to the upside, suggesting that the euro area economy has not been affected by the latest supply shortages as many may have believed, the new pandemic-related measures keep concerns over the future performance of the economy elevated. Even the German IFO survey said that business morale deteriorated for the fifth straight month in November, highlighting investors' anxiety even before the imposition of new restrictions. Now, what's more, expectations over a sooner rate increase and a faster rate path by the Fed raised speculation that the ECB may also raise rates sooner, with participants fully pricing in such a move next year. However, with the risk of further economic slowdown in Eurozone, we don't believe that ECB officials will dare to think of something like that. Today, we will get to hear from President Lagarde, and we expect her to reiterate the view that raising interest rates now to rein in inflation could choke off the Eurozone's recovery. We expect the minutes from the latest ECB meeting due out an hour ahead of Lagarde's speech to deliver the same message. This is likely to keep the euro pressured, especially against the US dollar, as well against the pound. Pound traders have raised bets that the Bank of England could hit the hike button next month, after Bank of England Governor Andrew Bailey said that they are still on a path towards raising interest rates, and after the latest CPIs accelerated by more than expected. Governor Bailey will speak today as well, and another round of hawkish remarks could encourage some more pound buying. Now, as for the rest of today's events, besides the ECB minutes and the speeches from ECB President Lagarde and Bank of England Governor Bailey, we will also get to hear from ECB's Elderson and Schnabel, as well as by the Bank of England MPC member Haskell. Otherwise, the calendar is very light, with Wall Street set to stay closed in celebration of the Thanksgiving Day. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So, goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.